Namaste, my beautiful queens, patrons, my gorgeous goddesses. The spread, I will try to start fast. This spread I want to show you is unbelievable. You can look at any person. You can do that, such a spread at yourself. I'm having shadowy deck because it shows all the shadows of the person. We're gonna look at your man. So I want you to think about one man you want to know about, and you will know everything about it because it's 9-card spread. But I am gonna get 2 cards for each position, so I'm going to tell you everything about him. I'm going to use 18 cards. Questions which we will ask, and I'm not going to put all the 18 down here because there is not enough space here. I will show you the cards. So how people see him means what mask or image he created and how he shows himself to people. Second, how he really is, really, at his very core, how he is. Even those two positions give incredible knowledge, being honest with you, sometimes in number one position, how he presents himself to people, and number two, how he is at his very core, can be completely different story. Number three position, his intellect. What does it mean, intellect? How he sees life, how he sees people, how he treats people. Does he manipulate people, or he's honest with them? So on, everything about it. Number four, human material world, how much things mean to him, career, finances, power. Number five, situations he feels comfortable at, just like fish in water. Number six, situations he avoids. Number seven, his strength. Number eight, his weakness. And number nine, as I said, I'm going to do 2 cards on each position. Nearest future, let's say within 6 months, his nearest future with you, or you can think with you or without you. I'm just gonna say nearest future, and you yourself determine, is it with you or just his nearest future. And whatever spirits are gonna tell you about this man, you know, it can be about anyone. It can be about your friend, your boss, your love interest. You can see in this spread, you can also see yourself as well. I just want to show you the whole thing. It's unbelievable. So we are going to look at your man, and we're not going to leave no stone, no rock unturned. Answering, asking the spirits of fire, earth, air, and water, the divine, the guides, and the keepers to give us the answers to our questions about that man. Each one of those women watching this video, listening to this video, is going to be thinking to my forehead, to my mouth, to my heart. We're just going to go straight to it. How people see him, how he presents himself to the world, how he presents himself to the people. Oh, he presents himself to the people as a Ace of Cups and Four of Pentacles. So, of course, he is such a decent, he's a decent, wonderful man, and he is deep, and he is loving, and he is sincere, but at the same time, he presents himself to the world, to people, as someone who is very careful, who thinks before he does everything and anything, who knows what he wants not, who is also has some stubbornness, who achieves what he wants, but he doesn't like to risk. He does show it to people. He loves status. He shows it because status quo is very important for this person. He shows it. He doesn't hide it. He likes to be considered as someone who appreciates stability, who appreciates his family to be taken care of, to be protected, to be so he's overprotective and protective over things he lives. He is not a poor man. Four of Pentacles is never poor man, and the position and money are very important to him. He also probably is a businessman, probably a father of a family, probably married and has children. If he doesn't, then he considered the marriage with the right woman. Unfortunately, that type of a man usually chooses to marry a woman, means to call that woman his wife, not relying on the, feelings, but he likes the woman to match his position and his status. He shows it to the world less than, of course, he shows the Ace of Cups, because he likes to show himself as responsible. He likes to show himself as the one who has status, who appreciates his status, who protects what he believes, who is practical. He's practical, but at the same time, he wants to show himself to the world as the Ace of Cups, and he is so deep, and he is so wonderful, and he is so he wants to show that he does have emotions, and his feelings are true and deep, and he's ready to help everyone, and he's generous. He shows, this is the one he shows. He shows it to the piece. He is generous. He is altruistic. He is happy with his life. His soul is in his harmony with the world and with everything else, and he's in a good mood. He's all positive. He's positive, and he likes to treat people in a positive, respectful way. Yeah, I'm repeating myself. This is how he presents himself to the world. That's not how he really is. We will see how he really is. So he, it's like a glass of champagne. He likes to present himself as this conjunction of really good man, really, really good, positive, responsible man, but at the same time deep, wonderful, and like a glass of champagne, making everybody happy. Loves to be attractive in the eyes of people, and also likes to present himself as someone who has no enemies. This is how he likes to present himself to the world. Now let us see. This deck is amazing. Very clear, very true. The one which I'm a little scared with this deck, because this deck, gives you the answers. Probably you don't even want to see them, but how he really is, how this man really is. Maybe he's really like this, maybe not. How he really is, cards. How he really is, Seven of Swords. He's really, he's Seven of Swords. He's totally opposite. Oh, he's lying. Oh my God. Two of Swords and he's Swords. Completely not what he... 100% not what he shows to the world. So we have Swords. We have Swords here. And we have the Seven of Swords. You see, the trickster, the manipulator, the one which I have already said so much about. Seven of Swords, that I cannot even tell you. I think most of you, all of you already know what a Seven of Swords means. It's a very negative card in love, spread, relationship. And Two of Swords, you see, he's looking at himself in the mirror holding two swords. So he's standing only for himself. He is nothing. What he presents himself to the world, his true core is nothing like this. So of course, Seven of Swords is a man who is not a coward, definitely not, is not a coward. He's very smart, extremely intellectual, and extremely sly. So he can achieve pretty much anything he puts his mind to. If he wants to become a politician, he will. If he wants to become a movie star, he will. If he wants to become a successful businessman, he will. But this one, if he has to use a lie, if he has to use a manipulation, if he has to press the buttons, if he has to wear a mask, we already clearly saw that this is how he presents himself to the world, and we already clearly see that he wears masks brilliantly, because this is how not just how he presents himself to the world, this is how the world also see him. So of course he doesn't consider he's lying, he consider he is using different methods of achieving achieving goals he wants, and he considers reality more interesting for himself and for the other. He loves intellectual games, he loves mysteries, he loves those hints and half hints, he loves mind games, he loves playing with people. He can play with one person, he can play with 70 or 7,000 people. He is this what poker face, they say, he can bluff, but unfortunately he can of course be cruel and calculating and play with so-called mark card. Unfortunately, moral principles are not there. He's very he can achieve anything. He's smart, he's sly, he manipulates people, use people, very intellectual, very well read, but unfortunately remorses, regrets, feeling guilty, feeling responsible are not his thing. He's not reliable. And of course, it's a spy, double agent, or, you know, man who travels selling deep secrets. So of course, Two of Swords, he is himself, he is all in himself. He is one of those which I have spent so many times describing you, the narcissistic type of personality. And Two of Swords in this deck, of course, someone who, when he has a problem, he's never gonna solve that problem openly. Also, it's like in this deck, it's an actor. In this deck, you see a man in front of the mirror. It's an actor, and he is capable to create any drama and act any role which he needs to use in order to get his way. If he has to, pretty much anything he considers he needs, he will get it this way or that way. So as you can see, absolutely not, this man is not a type of a man he presents himself to the world. Unfortunately not. Intellect, how he sees a life, how he sees people, how he treats people. He treats people anyhow he wants. He presents himself. We already saw that he presents himself as a Ace of Cups. Right here we see King of Cups, especially if you're asking about water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, but it doesn't really matter because we have a lot of swords here. So how he sees a life, his intellect, very intellectual, very smart, how he treats people, how he behaves with people. He behaves with people as an emperor. The thing is, if people get in trouble while doing something with him, he consider, how to tell you, it's unfortunately he considers himself not the center of the universe, but pretty much close to that. So we have a king and we have an emperor. So of course, he only takes into consideration his own wishes and his own desires and his own goals. Intellect, how he sees life from the point of view very simple, which is called, if you don't, you have to be a shark. So if you don't eat others, then others are gonna eat you. So you're gonna be eaten. If you don't eat, you're gonna be eaten. But at the same time, he doesn't consider himself the, you know, a cold-hearted beast. No, he considers himself somehow the King of Cups. He considers that even if he brings pain, and of course the King of Cups is very famous at building and creating love illusion, and creating such emotions and feelings. The problem is, if you take Seven of Swords and you take King of Cups and Emperor, this man creates in a woman such enormously strong pull and enormously strong feelings that a woman has very difficult time to come out of such illusion, even if illusion becomes clear to such a woman. Because we have Seven of Swords right here, it's difficult because he is what comes to love and relationship. He can act as a King of Cups. He can charm you. He can make you lose your mind. I have a whole video about the King of Cups and how he can make you forget your own name and create this bubble in which you absolutely lose the connection with reality. Especially Scorpios can do it, but pretty much King of Cups, he can have any water sign in his chart, in Vedic or a Western, or he can have rising water sign. But Scorpios, Cancer, Pisces, a water king can create such a situation in which you start it's like, you know, if you you start thinking and believing that you can breathe underwater, unfortunately, of course, King of Cups creates an illusion, and he is the one who controls the situation. He gives you the illusion that you controlling the situation. You have some power over him. He plays his game. Don't forget, Seven of Swords, he's extremely unbelievable genius at wearing masks and playing games. It's the man like this. So very, very interesting man. If you don't get into relationship with him, but he is an emperor, of course. So all people are there to serve him one way or the other, either for emotional pleasure or mind gaming playing, either for using them in achieving his goals. Because he's an emperor, he really his position means a lot to him. His power means a lot to him. This means everything to him. But in a love relationship, he will present himself as the King of Cups. Him and material world, additional information, him and material world, how he is in material, am I holding it upside down? Five of Swords and Tower. Five of Swords and Tower. He will do anything not to allow his material world to collapse as a tower. Anything and everything. Five of Swords. Victory. Victory. Victory at any cost. He will sacrifice anyone and anything to keep his position as an emperor on his throne. Being honest with you, it's a little scary guy. You know, ooh, situations he feels comfortable at. He feels very comfortable at what situation. There is the Three of Wands and Seven of Pentacles. He feels very comfortable at talking. It's funny, you know, in the situations when he has to talk about, because you see Three of Wands and Seven of Pentacles, he can talk about higher purposes. Like he's good at talking. He can convince people. He can even motivate people, because we're having an emperor here. He can motivate people of, like right here, fight a dragon, that he can come out and fight any dragon. And he, like talking about no higher material, about nobility of the world, about people must treat each other fairly, and people must be just to each other, and the children have to be fed. And if you have to, if you receive something you want right away, you're not gonna appreciate it. So you need to know how to wait. You need to understand how to wait. You have to learn how to wait. So when you receive it, you appreciate what you receive. So he is really good at a situation he feels comfortable at, as the teaching, motivating, and convincing. Convincing everyone that he believes in high ideals. He could be also talking very well about some religious subject, spiritual subject. He could even be some guru or knowledgeable in some subjects he discusses. So he is very good at that. He feels very comfortable at that. Situations he avoids. What situations he would not want to find himself at. The World and a Three of Cups. He situations he is avoid connected with love and relationship, and situations he is avoid the world. In this card, you see the true spirit of the world here. The thing is that he really tries to avoid any situations which force him to look into the depths of himself, to listen to himself, to admit where he came in his life, how he went into, because this I call going into the shadow, being into the shadow, living into the shadow. Because we clearly see here that for this man, the game, the feeling that he has power over the minds of people, over the thoughts of people, over the situations, over his own life. As an emperor, of course, to him, we can see that his position is extremely important, and this is the most important in the world to him. So we see situation he avoids, and we see couple, we see a man and a woman holding hands, and this situation he avoids, of course, any true deep emotions and feelings. He unfortunately has problems, as we can see clearly here in Seven of Swords right here. Of course, this is someone who has issues with empathy, with compassion, with care, love. So unfortunately, of course, we see kind of cold man, strong powerful, the one who can speak, the one who can make people believe that he is very deep and wonderful. But at the same time, the situations connected with love and feelings and connected with necessity to look deep inside, he avoids any possible and impossible ways, anything like that. These are situations he feels uncomfortable, so he would avoid such things. Does he have strength? I mean, except for him being able to press all the buttons on everyone, his strength, his weakness. His strength is that he can start things all over again, the Fool. If he falls and something he started has collapsed, his strength is he can get up and he can start it all over. And if he, for example, loses his empire, he will be able to rebuild his empire over again. And his weakness, we have Five of once, and this is the situation in which he has to use their real strength, not manipulation, not but honest fight. You see right here, I don't know how clearly you see it, you see this man, he needs to cross this gap, and he needs to get to the other side. He needs to break through some difficult situation in life, and he must only use his he has to be honest in it. He has to use what he has at hands right now, without anyone, without pressing anyone's button, without using anyone, without anyone's, you know, doing it for him. And this would be his weakness. He would not be good at that. He needs to, we have this expression, to get the hot, how to say, like in a fireplace, we call it, you use somebody else's hands to get the burning logs from a fireplace. You don't use your own hands. So when in situations when he needs to fight of what he wants or needs or desires or wishes himself without anyone else, and being honest, he would be weak. And his strength is, as I already said, being able to start from 0 point. His nearest future with you, I mean, if you still want to be dealing with such a guy, we will see. His nearest future with you. Oh, I'm putting it. Knight of Wands and Empress. Now, that's interesting. Now, this is very interesting. So, the Emperor finally got... Where is he? Emperor finally got not a little girl he was playing with, but gets himself the Empress. Not just an Empress. I want you to pay attention that Empress in this deck is similar to the card of strength, because she has a tiger here. And it's also similar to Queen of Wands. But still, this is Empress and this is Emperor. The thing is that you see that he has attributes of power in his hands, but she has the power over so-called the wild beast in a man, because the strength card signifies anima and animus, means feminine and masculine, and so she has the power over his masculine. The thing is that, well, I don't know if you want to be dealing with this man, but probably you're the only one who can, but the thing is that Knight of Wands, of course, Knight of Wands wants the hot, beautiful lovemaking, obviously, because Knight of Wands signifies the hot, incredible lover, and he's like, as soon as he even thinking about you, he lightens up like a match, so you really, you impress him again. I'm not gonna talk love here, because we could see that at the core, this is the Two of Swords, and this is Seven of Swords. But it's a huge passion, and he might try to press your buttons to get you into the bed with him. You are such a treasure, you know, you are such a treasure. Of course, he would want to get the power over you. He would want to make you do what he wants, how he wants it. Of course, he would want to press all your buttons. Of course, he would want Empress fall from her throne to his feet and beg him for love. Of course, he's not a man who is responsible, and he's gonna, you know, come and tell you, I want to stay with you for the rest of my life. But interesting thing that he's dreaming about you, fantasizing about you, a lot of sexual desire. But girls, you have to understand, do you really want to deal with such a man? Because yes, you, you're not gonna allow him to play with you. You're not gonna allow him to throw you from your throne to his feet. No way. Probably you've done it in the past. You're not gonna do it anymore. You are not going to let him use you as a resource. You're not gonna let him lie to you. Plus, right now you already know how he truly is. He doesn't wanna, you know, let you go and get on the boat and sail away from him. He's too he is too proud. He is, he never had a woman like you in his life. He never had a woman who would resist and stand in her power. Because the thing is, as soon as you become a little weaker with your emperor, he's gonna, you know, lose interest and just go get himself someone else. As long as you become anything less than this woman, I'm gonna put her closer, anything less than this woman, he will lose interest. And as soon as you hold yourself at Empress, he will be going crazy about you. But in the nearest future, all I can see is the only thing he's thinking about is you. Of course, he's not thinking about you from point of view, you know, throw the world to your feet. He is thinking more how he can have you fall to him and beg him for love. But that's not gonna happen. But the nearest future, he's gonna go and drive himself crazy thinking of you and wanting you. This is what we have so far in this reading, my beautiful empresses and queens. I hope you enjoy this incredible spread, and I will talk to you later. Namaste.